Fertiliser research is really important because nutrients aren't used 100% effectively by most crops. We really need to improve the efficiency of uptake because, number one, that helps the farmer. We also need to reduce the losses to the environment where nutrients get moved into the atmosphere or into waterways, and that really can affect the environment in a negative way, so we really want to minimise those losses to the environment.
So I'm Andrew Barr, I'm a fifth generation farmer in the Adelaide Plains area, and I do a little bit of consulting on the side. Our fertilisers are absolutely vital to our cropping system. We have three main soil types, two of which are inherently very ancient, infertile, and they're high pH, they have high phosphorus binding indices, and so if we are to get anywhere near our water limited yield, we need annually to apply a considerable amount of phosphorus, nitrogen and sulfur and zinc as well. So the features we look in our fertiliser options are, can we source it locally? Does it have the analysis that matches the gaps in our nutrition profile that we know from our soil testing and plant testing we need? Does it have a good physical structure that will go through our augers, our seeders, our trucks, those sorts of things without degrading? And so they are the really important things.
Our research in the centre is really looking, trying to improve the efficiency of phosphorus use, either through granular or liquid products, and trying to improve the efficiency of trace element use, particularly zinc, because that's the major trace element needed here.
So we've done a lot of work on sulfur in the past few years. There's basically two sources of sulfur in fertilizer, elemental sulfur and sulfate. Elemental sulfur is cheaper and it doesn't leach, while you can have a lot of leaching losses with sulfate, but it only becomes slowly available to the plant. So we've been trying to understand how quickly it becomes available to plant and also trying to enhance that rate by modifying the fertilizer.
So what I do, I use a new material called graphene in order to improve our fertilizer formulations. So we're using graphene as a carrier of nutrients, or as well as coating of granules for co-granulation as well, for improving physical properties, etc.
Our focus has been on coatings for fertilizer granules to improve the physical properties, because farmers are finding dust issues and hard caking issues, and this results in really poor distribution in paddocks. So our focus has been using environmentally friendly coatings so that they degrade in the soil and they're going to still release the nutrient to the plant.
We also want to improve fertilisers in an environmentally sustainable way, so that any of the ingredients or the formulations we develop are going to not be harmful to the environment. It's really important also for the farmer that we improve the physical quality of the product, because the product needs to get from the factory to the soil without breaking down, without degrading, without caking. So we're focusing both on physical quality, nutrient use efficiency, and reducing environmental losses. If you want more information on the research we're doing and the outcomes that we're trying to achieve, please just go to our website and have a look at our research programs and our current publications. You'll find all the information there.